The lesson today is on classifying triangles. And when you classify triangles, we're just naming them. And I've got a fun way to teach you guys how to name the triangles and keep all the names straight between them. At the Triangle Hospital, when the little baby triangles are born, they're given a name. They're given a first name and a last name. And these little triangles are named because of the lengths of their sides and their angles. So we're going to learn how to name baby triangles just like they do in the Triangle Hospital. Understand? We're going to give them a first name and a last name. Their first name depends on their sides. We're going to look at their sides only for their first name. When the baby triangle has sides that are all equal, his name is equilateral. He's given that name when all the sides are equal. Now you're going to see this two ways. Sometimes they're going to give you a triangle and they're going to put one little hash mark in each side. Other times they could give you a triangle and they could tell you that it's 2 inches on each side. Either way, as long as each side is the same, all sides are equal, his first name is equilateral. Now the second name they give out, a little unusual. His name is Isosceles. Sounds like some sort of Greek mythology character. I always think of Hercules. Isosceles is given his name when he has two, count them, two sides are equal. Only two. And we all know triangles have three sides. So you're going to have a triangle that looks like this, where this side and this side are even, but this side over here, it's another length. A lot of times they don't even give you the lengths. It doesn't matter. I can look at this and see the two hash marks on either side and know that these two sides are even, and this one's another unknown length. Sometimes they'll give you the lengths on the side, and this will be 4, and this will be 4, and this will be 2. As long as two sides are equal, his name is Isosceles. Now, the last name we're going to talk about, kind of unfortunate, his name is Scalene. This poor guy, he's all wonky. He has no equal sides. Every side is different. I always, when I see Scalene, I think of like some evil Harry Potter character. He's all wonky. This side might be 9. This side might be 7. This side might be 8. They're going to give you a triangle that either has 3 different lengths, or sometimes you'll see it where they do 1 hash, 2 hashes, and 3 hashes. So this is how we determine the first name of our triangles when we name them. Now the last names are a little bit easier because these are words you've seen since third grade. Their last name is given to them because of their angles. The last name is acute if all angles are acute. And just to review, an acute angle is less than 90 degrees. These are the small guys. He is less than 90 degrees. Sometimes you're just going to have to look at it and determine if it's an acute angle. Sometimes they'll tell you that it's 42 degrees. You'll see it both ways. But in order for it to be an acute, all three angles have to be acute. His last name is obtuse. If one, only one, angle is obtuse. These are the big, fat, chunky monkey angles. He's got a big old belly on him, right? These guys are more than 90 degrees. When you have an angle more than 90 degrees in a triangle, his last name is obtuse. And the last one, super easy to remember, is right. It is named a right triangle when one, only one, angle is a right angle. Right angles are signified by these little boxes in the corner. These are 90 degrees. If it's 91, it's obtuse. If it's 89, it's acute. Only 90 degree angles are right angles. So you have a first name and a last name. Every triangle is going to have one. You look at the sides to classify your first name, and then you look at the angles for the last name.